Hey everybody, welcome to day 4 of VBS. I'm so glad you could join us today.
Today we'll be talking about a foundation of promise and how Jesus promises to always be with us. And you know, Jason, I was looking at this and it kind of looks like a tomb. And that's what our Bible story is about, is that even though Jesus died and was buried, he came back to life and he promised to never leave us.
That's right. So let's stand up as we sing our song. Join in with us. Hey everybody, thanks for joining us once again for our Bible study time. Yesterday we learned that on the last night Jesus spent with his disciples, he went to the Garden of Gethsemane to pray. He asked his disciples to remain awake and pray while he went further into the garden. Jesus was distressed or concerned because he knew he was going to die on the cross to save people from their sins. Jesus returned to the disciples 3 times and found them asleep each time. The last time he told the disciples to get up and follow him. Jesus knew the time had come to follow through with God's plan. Before we begin, let's say our VBS theme first together. I am sure of this, that he started a good work in you, will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6. Let's do it again. But this time, the verse is going to be on the screen with 4 blanks. And I want to see if you can fill in the blanks based on the verse we just read. Ready? Let's see if you can figure it out. Good job. Did you get them all? Let's read it again together. I am sure of this. That he started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6. Let's say the VBS motto together. Jesus, our strong foundation. Good job! Today is called Foundation of Promise. Today's Bible story is found in Matthew chapter 28. Let's check it out. Matthew chapter 28 says, Jesus was arrested for crimes he did not commit, beaten and nailed to the cross, where he died for the sins of all people. His body was placed in a tomb. A large stone was placed over the opening of the tomb. Guards stood by the tomb so no one could get in. The followers of Jesus believed their hope was gone. Early on Sunday morning, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, walked to the tomb. There had been a violent earthquake, and an angel of the Lord had come down from heaven. The angel rolled back the stone that had been placed in front of the tomb and sat on it. The angel had the appearance of lightning, and his clothes were as white as snow. The guards who had been placed in front of the tomb to guard Jesus' body were so frightened that they fainted and fell to the ground. When the women saw the angel, they were frightened, but the angel reminded them that Jesus had risen just as he had told them he would. The angel invited the women to come see where Jesus had been and then told them to go and tell Jesus' disciples what they had seen. Jesus met the women on the way and said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my disciples to leave for Galilee, and they will see me there." The women ran to tell the disciples the great news. Jesus is alive! They told the disciples to go to Galilee, where Jesus would meet them. The 11 disciples traveled to the mountain in Galilee, where Jesus had directed them to go. When the disciples saw Jesus, they worshipped him. Jesus said to the men, "Go and make disciples everywhere. Baptize people and teach them to do everything I have told you." Then Jesus made an amazing promise. He promised to be with them always. Today's story is very important to know and understand. Jesus will always love you. He loved you so much he was willing to die on a cross for your sins, for the things you did wrong. Isn't that amazing? Jesus chose to pay the price of the sins of all people. The good news is that Jesus didn't stay dead. What kind of emotion do you have knowing that Jesus will always love you? Let's check out our toolbox to see what we have today. Well, it's a nail. How does a nail help us remember today's Bible story? Jesus died on the cross with nails in his hands for us, and he promised to always be with us. Let's look at it this way. Let's play a game. I'm going to show you a series of pictures of machines found at construction sites. Then I'll show the pictures again, but this time I'm going to leave out a picture and you have to guess what it is. Ready? First is dump truck. Second, bulldozer. Third is crane. And fourth is forklift. Now, I'm going to mix them up. And then we're going to see if you can guess the one that I left out. Number one, forklift. Number two, dump truck. Number three, bulldozer. Okay, the first one. I promise that this one is a bulldozer. I promise it's a bulldozer. Ready? Uh-oh. Was it a bulldozer? No, it was a crane. Even though I promised you that it was something else, it turned out to be a crane. How did that make you feel? What's a promise? A promise is to make a statement that you will do something. Today we learned about a promise. Jesus promised to never leave the men. He also promises to always love you. Jesus has never and never will break a promise. Isn't that amazing info to know? This week we've been learning about building on the love of Jesus. Just like a foundation is important to a building to keep it from falling down, you are building a foundation of understanding of knowledge of Jesus. So far, you've learned about the foundation of love, forgiveness, worth, and today we added promise. Let's pray together. God, We come before you. We thank you for the promise that you sent Jesus to this earth. Father, Jesus died on the cross using nails, but most importantly, he was raised from the dead 3 days later. So Father, thank you for that promise, and thank you for the promise knowing that we can pray and you hear us, and that you forgive us. And when you forgive us, you never leave us and you never forget about us. So Father, thank you for people in our life that remind us of that promise, and even you when you remind us of that promise. So thank you for your promises. Amen. Let's check in on the Worthy family as they serve God in Italy. Let's watch.
Hi guys, every morning at 7 a.m., our family does a family devotion before we head off to school. Our school is real close and we can walk there in like 5 minutes. School here is a lot like school in the U.S., except here we learn more languages because Italy is home to so many people from different countries.
Sono un cavallo fatto di legno.
I'm learning 3 languages, French, Latin, and Italian. In Italian, Jesus loves you is Gesù ti ama. Can you say that? Gesù ti ama.
Cosa facciamo domattina?
Si fa il lavoro di cavallo di Troia.
Oh, bravo!
School's another great place to tell people that Jesus loves them. Throughout the year, we host outreach parties at our house, where we invite a whole bunch of our friends from school to celebrate things like holidays and special events. And there we can tell them about Jesus.
This area of Italy is where the story of Pinocchio was written. You know the story of the little wooden boy whose nose would grow every time he told a lie? You couldn't always trust what Pinocchio said, but we can always trust what God says.
In Matthew, Jesus says, "Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And remember, I am with you always, to the very end of the age."
Not only is that an awesome promise, but it's also a command for us. Go tell others about Jesus, and that's what we do.
And one way we do that is by hosting a really big VBS camp during the summer. It's a lot like VBS in the States, with games, activities, and a lot of stories about Jesus and how he loves us. VBS is so much fun, so remember God's promise. He will always be with you, and go tell others.
Are gonna cave around me. I think about the way your love and grace and peace have found me. I remember what you said, you will never ever leave me. So I'm holding on to all your promises.
joining us for day 4 of Vacation Bible School. I can't believe it's almost over, Jason.
I know it, but we've had so much fun and we're so glad that you joined us today. Tune in tomorrow to see where we are going to be. See you then.